Hey everybody, thanks for dropping by. This is Ian with Rail City. Don't forget to subscribe if you find this video helpful and check out the new music playlist on my channel for new stuff, cool new stuff that my my band puts out. Today we're going to be taking a look at one of the most bang for your buck mixing tools out there, as Mike Sr. puts it in his book, Mixing Secrets for the Small Studio. This is the Avantone Mixcube. This is a modern emulation of the Oratone speaker that was made famous after the dude who mixed Thriller did the majority of that mixing on an Oratone. And then a lot of modern mixers nowadays use Oratones to mix, like the guy who does Kendrick Lamar's records. I'm gonna mic up the Mixcube and compare how it sounds to the to music played through this M-Audio AV40 cheap studio monitor. So this will give you a good idea of what to expect if you're looking at shelling out $250 for a Mixcube. You're gonna notice the Mixcube has a much more hyped mid-range, has almost no bass or high end, whereas this guy will give you a good bass line to compare it to. Things are gonna sound a lot more the way you're used to when you listen to music coming through this.
The gram for they say I do. The type to blast a nigga that get caught when he cheat. But your niggas piping your best friend as we speak. Happy Mother's Day.
That just mean your pussy work.
Anyone could bust a nut, but who can put in work?
Yeah, back at it again, bitch. Yeah, back to set the record and the train, bitch. Yeah, money still the mission, but I been rich. Got to keep the fucking door at the hinge. Stay on point like a syringe. Back again, bitch, I'm back at it again.
Back again.
Setting trends, setting motherfucking trends.
Setting trends, yeah.
Money feel the motion, but I've been rich.
Been rich.
I'm back at it again,
back
bitch.
Again.
Back again, bitch, I'm back at it again.
Back again.
Setting trends, setting motherfucking.
For they say I do. The type to blast a nigga that get caught when he cheat. But your niggas piping your best friend as we speak. Happy Mother's Day.
That just mean your pussy work.
Anyone could bust a nut, but who can put in work?
Yeah, back at it again, bitch. Yeah, back to set the record and the train, bitch. Yeah, money still the mission, but I been rich. Gotta keep the fucking door out the hinges. Stay on point like a syringe. Back again, bitch, I'm back at it again.
Back again.
Setting trends, setting motherfucking trends.
Setting trends, yeah.
Money still the motion, but I been rich.
Been rich.
I'm back at it again,
bitch.
Back again, bitch. I'm back at it again.
Back again.
Setting trends, setting motherfucking trends.
Setting trends,
yeah.
Yeah.
So why do people like these simple and kind of bad sounding speakers here? Well, there's really three reasons. The first, this is a mono speaker. So any sort of stereo issues that are going on in your mix, any sort of mono summing problems or any sort of phase canceling that's taking place between your two stereo channels, this is gonna pick up on it right away because it's combining the two channels and the two stereo channels and pointing that stuff out. And if you do like the guy who mixes Kendrick Lamar stuff and mix on this right from the get-go and do like 75% of your mix on it, it's really going to help prevent stereo issues that you have to fix later on. So that's the first reason. The second reason is this speaker only has a single driver. I don't really know what that means, but supposedly that gives you a more accurate picture of how your mix sounds compared to speakers that have a more complicated driver setup inside them, I suppose. And then the third reason people like these speakers is they don't have much low end or high end. They solely focus on the mid-range, and high end and low end are like crack. They get you all pumped up, and you know, you might add gobs of bass to your mix or lots of airy high end and think that that's doing it for your mix, but you may have neglected the mid-range, which is really, really important for certain instruments like guitars. The mid-range is where a lot of energy in your song will lie, and it's easy to neglect it if you're always distracted by the high end and the low end. And then on cheap speakers, like for instance department store speakers, a lot of times the mid-range is the only portion of the frequency range that'll make it through. So it's really important that you focus on that, you know, let's say 300 hertz to 1.5 kilohertz range. And this speaker makes it really, really easy and kind of forces you to do that. I did want to add that something really nice and I think smart and maybe even essential to pair with the Mixcube is something like the Sennheiser HD6 Mix headphones. So when you're using your Mixcube, it's going to do a lot of things for you. It's going to force you to fit all your instruments into a mono space. You know, you're not able to use stereo as a crutch to make everything really big. And then when it collapses to mono, none of it fits. You know, those same issues that you're hearing in mono, they're still present in stereo. Just mono makes them that much worse. And if you can have something super clean and everything fits together in mono, it's going to sound that much better in stereo. But after you're done doing, you know, the majority, if not all your mix on the Mixcube, two things are going to be lacking. You're not going to have any panning because it's in mono, and then you can't hear the low end, let's say below 100 hertz at all on the Mixcube, so your low end's going to be all wonky. These headphones are really good to pair it with. A lot of people, I think rightfully so, rat on doing a lot of mixing on headphones. For whatever reason, you know, I don't claim to be an expert mixer, but I'm a lot better than I was a couple years ago. Speakers do allow you to make better mix choices, I think, than headphones. It's a lot more common for stuff to sound really good on headphones and then it sounds like crap on speakers than it is for stuff to sound really good on speakers and then crap on headphones. If stuff sounds good on speakers, it usually sounds good on headphones too. But anyway, where was I going with that? Oh yeah, the one good thing about headphones is they're a lot better, in my opinion, for panning decisions. Stuff that you tweak a little bit that you might not hear on your studio monitors, you can hear those little tweaks on your headphones a lot better. Specifically, I really like these Sennheiser mix headphones. So these are really good for making your panning decisions after the Mixcube. And then these and a lot of other closed back mixing headphones out there have a lot of bass response. Really good for figuring out how your low end needs to be adjusted. And it's very rare that after having done my mix through the Mixcube and then having made some corrections on these headphones and then listening to it again on the Mixcube just to make sure what I've done on these headphones generalizes back to mono. It's really rare that once I put, you know, the work I've done on these two monitoring systems on my main monitors that there's a lot that needs to be done. So yeah, your mono mid-range speaker and your very stereo sensitive, bass sensitive headphones are a very, very powerful combination in your mixes. Just giving you a little tour of the architecture of the Mixcube here. A little mini tour. We've got the cone here. There's no cover, so you have to be really careful with it. I actually saved the styrofoam that came in the package of this so I can transport it more easily when need be. I just moved this across the United States from Virginia to Oregon. So that method works pretty well, keeping that styrofoam on it. It's got the nice little Avantone logo here. And then on the back, you can see this has an input for, you know, where you're wiring your mix into. You're going to need a cast line mono summing cable to put the signal in here. Anything else is going to make it sound weird. Once again, that's cast line, C-A-S-T-L-I-N-E, mono summing cable. And then right here you have a ground switch. The speaker will buzz if the ground isn't on, so that's a nice touch. This is your volume right here. This is your on switch, and here's where you wire your power supply into. So pretty simple setup on the back. You can see here this is designed in the USA but made in China. And then this is your, I think it's called a heat sink. It gets hot while you run it and I guess helps dissipate some of the heat from the speaker. There you have it, folks. That's how an Avantone Mixcube sounds compared to regular studio monitors. I hope between those audio samples and my advice earlier on, you're able to form a better opinion about whether an Avantone Mixcube, or for that matter, an Auratone speaker, is a good fit for you and what you need to make your music sound good. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments and feel free to check out my channel if you're into gear or music in general. That's all I post about. And I hope you have a great day.